I'm Darla Timian.
I'm her mom.
And I am Chris Burkhard, and I am Peyton's mom.
I found out on June 13th of 2018 with acute promyelocytic leukemia, which is the most fatal of the leukemias, but also the most curable leukemia. I found out about 3 o'clock in the afternoon, and at 4:30 I was in the hospital.
My first bout of breast cancer was in 2010, and I was 34 at the time. It was quite a shock being so young. I didn't know someone who was 34 could get breast cancer. I just thought that was for older women.
So my grandma Jenny was diagnosed with endometrial cancer in the fall of 2010, and I was 10 years old at the time, and I remember my grandma came over and my parents set my brother and I downstairs, and they wouldn't tell us why. I thought it was very bizarre, and they said, just watch TV. And of course I didn't listen, and I went and put my ear up next to the stairs, and I was listening to them, and they were just talking about how my grandma had just found out that she had cancer, and they were talking about what they were gonna do. And I was still young at this time, so I didn't understand really everything, but I was old enough to know that something was wrong.
My grandpa on my dad's side, Grandpa Jensen, he was diagnosed with non-Hodgkin's lymphoma this past fall. I actually found out through a phone call because I don't get to go home very often, so that was pretty tough. And I don't know, he's just always been a really big support system for me, and like has gone to almost every single one of my games since I was a little kid.
And then in 2014, I had a recurrence. Totally came out of the blue. I really didn't think that I would get breast cancer again, but I did, basically in the same spot, but it just was a little bit further to the left, and I had some cancer cells in my lymph nodes under my arm. So, which meant another surgery, removal of a ton of lymph nodes, and chemotherapy again, losing my hair again. And this time I did radiation therapy after the chemotherapy was done. I didn't have radiation done the first time, but the second time the doctors said that this time I will need it.
So in 2014, in April, my grandma Carolyn was diagnosed with breast cancer. So I was a little bit older, more mature then. I knew more about breast cancer. It's a cancer that's talked about quite often. My grandma had radiation, and she's on a trial drug right now, and so that's hopefully going to prevent her from getting cancer again.
The leukemia I had in its acute form is, if you don't catch it within the first week that you have it, it is extremely fatal. So basically when I went into the hospital on Friday, if they didn't get it under control, he said by Monday you might be a goner. That's how fast acting it is. At the time when I was in the hospital on Friday, 82% of my white blood cell count that my body was producing was all cancer. So it was a very, very fast acting leukemia. So I got lucky. So I call it 2 days to death is what I had. 2 days to death.
Actually, like, really kind of hit me when he came to, I don't know what game it was, but he came to one of our home games, and he was going to be starting treatment that week coming, and so that was kind of like the last game that he was going to be able to come to for a while. And we went out to eat, and I just broke down when we were at dinner, and just realizing how big of an impact he's had on my basketball career. I knew he did, but I just never took the time to sit down and think about it. And I just wouldn't be the type of player or even be playing Division I basketball without his love and support for my dreams.
Anytime you hear cancer, it's just mentally draining. It's scary, you don't know what's gonna happen. It's sad because you know that they're going through so much pain and they can't do the things that they normally would be doing. And to see them like almost in a state of helplessness, they can't do anything for themselves, they can't control it.
But just got through it and wore the wig and the caps again. And but I will say, when I did get home every day after work, the wig and the cap came off.
Came right off. As soon as she walked in the door, it was like, threw it off.
And I'd be itching my head. I would let the kids rub my head. I'm like, you guys, just rub my head. Because your head gets pretty sensitive going through chemotherapy. And so the first time through chemo, it was during the summer, and so it was hot, sweaty, and so I would just come home, take it off, and just sit there and just like, you guys, rub my head, please rub my head.
It definitely brought my grandma and I closer. I would always go to her house and clean and just hang out with her because she was not strong enough to be able to do the things that she normally did. She still had her awesome spirits though, even though she was super sick. It was a bonding time, honestly. We just got really close through this time and our whole family just came together for her because she is our rock.
Cancer is just one of those dirty words, you know, and it affects so many people.
I'm sitting here and we're talking about my cancer. There are other Jack parents who have had their bouts of cancer.
Mm-hmm. And affected in different ways, and the Pink Game is great for the awareness of breast cancer and for those that are dealing with that. One thing I did learn at the Roger Maris is that all these cancers have different colors to them. You know, lung cancer is white, brain cancer is silver, leukemia is orange. It's just, you learn a lot, you know, once you are struck down with cancer and have to deal with it. And so to see the support that is out there for the Pink Game, it is, it's a wonderful thing.
That's for sure brought us closer together. We're a family and we play for each other. And when one of us struggles, we all struggle. And one of us feels pain, we all feel pain. Happiness, same thing. So I think when those type of things come up, we just always make sure that that person knows we have their back and that we're in this together and that they're not doing this alone.
It brings us all together. We've all been through so much with cancer being affecting us, and so it's really good that it brings us all together, and it's good to recognize how many people go through it, because there's so many people who have been affected by it and it's been so tough on them, so I think it's really good that we can recognize them.